Hi everybody, this is Mr. Duncan in England. How are you today? Are you okay? I hope so. Are you happy? I hope so. In today's lesson, we will take a look at a festival that comes once a year. It is a time when many people get together to enjoy each other's company. It is a magical time for all, but especially for children and the young at heart. In this lesson, we will share the experience of Christmastime.
What is Mr. Duncan doing?
Hello there. As you can see, I have my hands full today. This means that I have a large job to carry out. I'm very busy right now. I have my hands full.
I wonder what is in that box.
The festival of Christmas is a religious one. In fact, most of the holidays that exist around the world are based on the observance and following of one religious ceremony or another. The word holiday itself derives from the Old English word meaning holy day. Christmas is part of the Christian religion. The Christmas festival celebrates the birth of the Christian Messiah or Saviour. The Christmas celebrations have changed considerably over the years, with new ceremonies and celebrations being added as the years have gone by, many of which we will be taking a look at today. This month is proving to be a busy one for me. I have been doing all sorts of things. Today I'm on the roof of my house, fixing some festive lights to the railings above my garage. Have you noticed how important lights are during festivals and celebrations? Even the word light can have a significant meaning. We can see the light. This means that we have had a revelation. If a person suddenly changes their mind about something, or they have a great idea, we can say that they have seen the light. Something that was unclear before can now be seen vividly and can be understood well. That person has seen the light. These are called fairy lights. They are tiny lights that glow and twinkle. Fairy lights are often hung on Christmas trees. They create a magical atmosphere with their gentle glow. Some fairy lights flash or blink. Some are white, while others are multicoloured. The name fairy lights dates back to the late 1800s and became popular after they were used as a stage prop in the opera Ailanthe, written by the composers Gilbert and Sullivan. For the opera, small electric lights were placed on the actors who were playing fairies. The name fairy lights stuck and is still used to this very day. Did you know that originally candles were used as decorations? That does not sound very safe to me. Christmas time is a fun season for children of all ages, because this is the time when Santa Claus comes to visit. He is a jolly gift giver who every Christmas Eve travels all away from the North Pole on a magic sleigh pulled by flying reindeer to drop off presents for all the good boys and girls around the world. Not forgetting those big boys and girls as well. Santa Claus is also known by the name Father Christmas. He is a good-humoured fellow, dressed all in red, with a big white beard and a jolly laugh. Ho, ho, ho! So, if you have been good this year, perhaps Santa Claus will come to drop a present down your chimney. So, did you guess what was in the box? I suppose it was quite obvious. The size and shape of the box suggested something large and tall, perhaps even taller than me. Yes, of course, it was a Christmas tree. Each year I put a Christmas tree up in my house, and this year is no exception. My Christmas tree does not come complete. The Christmas tree comes in three sections. This is the bottom section. So before I can decorate it, I must construct the tree. I have to put the tree together first. The tree has to be assembled. This is the bottom part of the tree. It is the base of the tree. So that's the middle section in place. All that remains now is the top section. So there it is, my lovely Christmas tree. It's a very tall tree, and it took me a long time to set up. Its total height is 7 feet. That's even taller than me. Super duper Christmas tree. You're a super duper Christmas tree. Oh yes you are. So green and so lush. So nice to see. You are the world's best Christmas tree. This particular Christmas tree is very realistic. It is very true to life. From far away, it looks like a real tree. The putting up of a tree at Christmas stems from the old pagan ritual of tree worshipping. Some people believed that trees were alive. Others considered the tree as sacred and divine. In some cultures, a tree is planted after the birth of a child so as to help it grow strong and healthy. The practice of bringing a tree into the house at Christmas became popular over 2 centuries ago. It first began in Germany and slowly moved to other places. Here in Britain, we have been decorating our homes with a tree at Christmas for around 200 years. Originally, these trees were decorated with candles, and later other things were hung on it so as to add more colour. These days, we place many different things on our Christmas trees. We can take a look at some of these things now, if you like. When decorating a Christmas tree, you normally begin with the lights, as they are the most awkward things to arrange. I have gone for multicoloured lights. Putting Christmas tree lights up can be a little laborious. You need to slowly move around the tree, and while doing so, you position the lights on the tree. Some people start from the bottom, while others prefer to do it from the top. I normally begin at the bottom, so I know exactly where the wire for the lights will trail from to the wall socket. So, I start at the bottom of the tree and slowly work my way up. This action is called hanging or stringing. You are hanging the lights on the tree. You are stringing the lights up. These particular lights are low energy ones. In fact, almost all of the lights I'm using inside and outside use very little electricity. This shiny material is called tinsel. It is very eye-catching. It really gets your attention. Tinsel adds that all-important sparkle to the tree. It complements the lights by shimmering and sparkling. Tinsel is a very important part of the tree decor. You can also put tinsel in other places too. I always like to put some around my TV. Quite often the tinsel around the edge is more interesting than what is happening on the screen. If someone asks me what I watched on TV last night, I reply, "My lovely tinsel." So that's the tinsel on the tree. I only have one thing to say next. Balls. Yes, balls. You cannot decorate your tree without some nice shiny balls. Or, as they are more traditionally known, baubles. A bauble is a glass decoration normally associated with Christmas trees. These days, most baubles are made of plastic, so they do not break as easily as the old-fashioned glass ones. I have quite a selection of Christmas baubles here. The focal point of any Christmas tree is the top. Normally, on the top of a Christmas tree, you will put a fairy or a star. I have decided to go for a nice golden star. The star can, of course, be used as a religious symbol. It is a powerful emblem. I see the star as a symbol of hope and longevity. Stars always look so bright and cheerful. A clear starry night really is a wonderful sight. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Some people might say that underneath the Christmas tree is the most important place, because that is where the presents and gifts can be found after Santa has been on Christmas Eve. There are other things that you can put on your Christmas tree to brighten it up. These are imitation holly leaves with real pine cones dusted with paint to look like snow. They add a lovely winter look to the tree. This little robin has found a nice comfortable spot to perch on.
So, that is my tree all decorated and the lights are ready to be switched on. I will also be switching on my outside lights tonight.
So here we go, it's the moment we've all been waiting for. It's time to turn on my Christmas lights. I have the plug here. This plug leads all the way to my Christmas lights on the front of the house. So all I have to do now is put the plug into the socket. La la la. Here we go. It's time to turn on the Christmas lights. Shall we have a countdown? Okay. Everybody, together, let's count down from 10 to 1. Are you ready? 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's turn on those lights. If there is one thing that Christmas is well known for, besides Santa and snow, it must be the music that is played during this time. For some reason, people love to sing during momentous occasions and festivals. Birthdays, weddings, even funerals. There is always a song to go with an occasion, and Christmas is no exception. A song that has been written for Christmas can be called a carol, a Christmas carol. The word carol is another word for song or chant. Christmas carols usually have a religious theme. They can also be called hymns. A hymn is any song with a religious theme that is sung in church. You could describe it as a prayer set to music. If you are a regular viewer of my lessons, then you will know that I love food. And Christmas time is one of those periods when food becomes quite a feature. We often see taking a meal as a good way of socialising. You can eat together with one person or many people. From a cosy romantic dinner for two, right up to a huge party for many. You can eat formally at a table. You can eat informally from a selection of food that has been placed out. This is called a buffet. Formal dining normally means that you are seated at a table and the food is served to you by the host or by a waiter if you are eating in a restaurant. Eating is important for survival. But it also serves as a great way of bringing people together. The type of food eaten at Christmas is very specific. The main meal is meat and vegetables. The traditional meat eaten is turkey. A turkey is a very large bird, so it is perfect for feeding a group of people. The turkey is normally roasted in an oven. It is covered with oil or fat so as to help it cook. You baste the turkey. This stops the meat from drying out. As the turkey cooks, you must check that it is not drying out. You can use the natural juices from the meat to pour over the turkey while it cooks. If you undercook, it will be raw and not safe to eat. If you cook it too much, it will become dry and the meat will be tough. And that is the last thing you want, as nobody likes a tough, rubbery turkey. You can also put a paste made from seasoned breadcrumbs and herbs inside the turkey before cooking it. This is called stuffing. After the main meal, there is normally a sweet or dessert served. The Christmas pudding is what is traditionally served. The Christmas pudding is a rich, nutty, fruity food flavoured with spices and alcohol. There are different varieties of Christmas pudding. Then there is the mince pie. These are normally small individual pies filled with mincemeat, although it is not actually meat. The sticky filling is made from dried fruit and seasoned with spices, lemon juice, and alcohol. Not everyone likes these types of dessert, including me. Here in the UK, many people will sit down after lunch to watch Queen Elizabeth give her annual speech to this country and the Commonwealth nations around the world. This happens on every Christmas Day at 3 p.m. Of course, these days you can watch the Queen's speech on YouTube at any time. There are many fun traditions that go with Christmas. One of them is kissing under the mistletoe. Mistletoe is a type of parasitic plant. It normally lives off the water and nutrients of trees. A parasitic thing is something that attaches itself to another thing for survival. It is called a parasite. One thing lives off another thing. There are certain types of parasitic insect too. A tick is a type of insect that lives off the blood of an animal, such as a dog or a sheep. We can describe a person as a parasite if they use others to get what they want, such as money or favours. The act of kissing under the mistletoe started off around the 16th century in England. Before that, mistletoe was seen as a symbol of male fertility. The real origin of the kissing ritual is unclear, as there are a few possible explanations. However, nowadays it is common for people to steal a kiss at Christmas with a stem of mistletoe hanging above them. Look, I have a piece of mistletoe here. Would you like a kiss? Maybe instead of a special hello, I could send out a special Christmas kiss under my big piece of mistletoe. This is a Christmas cracker. It is a novelty item that helps to create a festive atmosphere. You normally pull a cracker with another person. Inside the cracker, there is a small prize and a party hat. Also contained in the cracker is a joke. More often than not, these jokes are very old and corny. A corny joke is obvious and predictable, but we all still laugh along. After all, it is Christmas. It is normal for gifts to be exchanged on Christmas Day.
Quite often the presents are placed under the Christmas tree, which is, of course, where Santa Claus leaves his too. The gifts are normally opened in the morning, but of course they can be opened later as the Christmas guests arrive. It would be fair to say that the way in which Christmas is viewed and observed has changed a lot over the years. Some people feel that the religious element has almost disappeared. For young people, Christmas is about parties and presents. For the older generation, the religious theme is still important. Many people usually attend late-night church services just before Christmas Day arrives. These days, people have a choice as to how they celebrate Christmas. There is the traditional way and the modern way, or in some cases, both. What is interesting about modern Christmas is that even those who do not follow any particular religion, such as myself, still get involved with the festivities. I would not class myself as a religious person. However, I still enjoy the atmosphere that Christmas brings with it. The colour, the joy, the food, and of course, the chance to share time with those you care about. I hope you have enjoyed this festive lesson, and I wish you well, wherever you are in the world. This is Mr. Duncan in England saying happy holidays to you. Take care until next time, and of course, ta-ta for now.
Ho, ho, ho.